Elon Musk reveals the Neuralink N1 brain-computer interface device and its future capabilities. Neuralink's show-and-tell started with Musk reminding the audience that going from prototype to production is extremely difficult and emphasizing that Neuralink has been working hard to start human trials. Elon Musk said Neuralink has submitted all of the required documentation to the FDA in order to start human trials, and therefore estimated that the N1 Neuralink device would see its first implant in the human brain within 5 to 6 months. Elon Musk reminded everyone that Neuralink treats its animal test subjects with great care and that they conduct extensive benchmark testing before implanting one of Neuralink's brain-computer interface devices into an animal. Musk went on to show a Neuralink monkey that was typing on a computer with its brain, spelling out various words for the presentation. When it comes to Neuralink's upgradeability, two monkeys named Sake and Pager have already been successfully implanted with the upgraded N1 brain-computer interface device and have shown no ill effects after using various versions of the device over the past 2 years. Elon Musk says that upgradeability is very important for their first production device because it will be much like the first iPhone in terms of basic features, and no one wants an old iPhone stuck in their body forever. In terms of Neuralink's application, Musk says that Neuralink can restore vision, even for someone who was born blind, and the company also believes that the Neuralink device will be able to provide full movement for quadriplegics by stimulating nerves throughout the spinal cord. Neuralink is currently creating a high-bandwidth generalized interface to the human brain, which requires safety, scalability, and access to various brain regions. The Neuralink N1 implant uses thin threads to connect to various areas of the brain, with the N1 brain-computer interface device being about the size of a quarter. The N1 devices have 1,024 channels, which are each used for both stimulating and recording brain activity with artificial intelligence. Another important piece of the puzzle is Neuralink's surgical robot, called the R1 robot, which will serve to implant the N1 BCI device into the brain using computer vision to avoid blood vessels while placing each thread exactly where needed. The R1 surgical robot already has 2 operating rooms in Neuralink's location in Austin, Texas, and they are in the planning stage of opening their own clinics in the future after they get approval from the FDA for clinical human trials in the U.S. In terms of applications, since 2021, Neuralink has been improving the speed and accuracy of the cursor to eliminate lag with great success thanks to the help of artificial intelligence. They are also working on various mouse and keyboard interfaces to be compatible with Neuralink's N1 brain-computer interface. Neuralink is already teaching its monkeys to write letters and numbers so it can get rid of display keyboards and improve the expected word-per-minute typing speed when human patients get to use the N1 implant next year. Because Neuralink's N1 implant is wireless, they have improved the battery of the device with a new charger that employs an aluminum battery base with a 6.78 MHz drive circuit to achieve double the battery life compared to before, which is also charged wirelessly, and they are already developing their next-generation charger using bidirectional near-field communication. The N1 brain-computer interface has a tiny onboard microprocessor, which they've used to carry out hill tests, but after testing became a bottleneck, the research team came up with a new system that allows them to rapidly iterate new hardware approaches for the N1 implant, which has served to accelerate their pace of progress. The R1 surgical robot will help neurosurgeons to implant Neuralink's N1 chip, and as they continue to improve their surgical device technology, it will automate more and more of the surgery, which will make the R1 robot and the N1 implant surgery procedure more and more affordable in the future. The next generation of Neuralink's potential capability is to restore eyesight in blind patients. In testing, Neuralink already implanted the N1 into the visual cortex of 2 monkeys named Code and Dash, and the brain-computer interfaces were able to record the receptive area of their visual fields. Lastly, to help people who have severed spinal cords, Neuralink has conducted tests demonstrating how the N1 BCI device can stimulate movement in animals using multiple implants throughout the spinal cord. The initial goal of the technology is to help people with paralysis regain independence through the control of computers and mobile devices. The devices are therefore currently being designed to one day give people the ability to communicate more easily via text or speech synthesis, to follow their curiosity on the web, or to express their creativity through photography, art, or writing apps. The N1 Link is a starting point for a new kind of brain-computer interface. As the technology develops, Neuralink aims to increase the channels of communication with the brain, accessing more brain areas and new kinds of neural information with the help of artificial intelligence. Neuralink believes this technology has the potential to treat a wide range of neurological disorders, to restore sensory and motor function, and eventually to expand how humans interact with each other and experience the world. Neuralink is designing its N1 link to connect to thousands of neurons in the brain, so that it may one day be able to record the activity of these neurons, process these signals in real time, and translate intended movements directly into the control of an external device. As a first application of the technology, Neuralink hopes to help people with quadriplegia, or ALS, by giving them the ability to control computers and mobile devices directly with their thoughts. Neuralink would start by recording neural activity in the brain's movement areas. As users think about moving their arms or hands, Neuralink would decode those intentions, which would be sent over Bluetooth to the user's computer. Users would initially learn to control a virtual mouse. Later, as users get more practice and the adaptive decoding machine learning algorithms continue improving, Neuralink expects that users would be able to control multiple devices, including a keyboard or a game controller. Neuralink hopes the first application will enable people with quadriplegia to control a point-and-click computer cursor. Neuralink believes there are many other potential future applications for the link. These may include restoring motor, sensory, and visual function, as well as treatment of neurological disorders. The company has not yet begun clinical trials and therefore doesn't have safety data in humans, but safety has been at the core of the design process. In particular, the link includes technical innovations intended to improve the safety of the surgical procedure compared to existing brain-computer interface devices or traditional neurosurgery. There is always risk associated with general anesthesia, which can be reduced by shortening the time of the procedure. Neuralink is designing the neurosurgical R1 robot so that it will be capable of efficient and reliable electrode insertion. This surgical robot is being designed to insert threads through a hole in the skull as small as 25 millimeters in diameter. Combined with other advancements in robotic surgical tooling, this may eventually allow us to eliminate general anesthesia and implant the device under conscious sedation. Inserting a device into the brain always carries some risk of bleeding. Neuralink is trying to reduce that risk by using micron-scale threads, inserted with a needle whose diameter is about the size of many neurons in the brain. Furthermore, because each thread is individually inserted, the neurosurgical robot is being designed so that it will aim each thread to avoid damaging blood vessels at or near the surface of the brain. Neuralink is currently focused on developing medical devices with the belief that these devices have the potential to help people with a wide range of injuries and neurological disorders, and hopes to develop treatments for many of these conditions in the coming years. They expect that as the devices continue to scale, and as the company learns to communicate with more areas of the brain, they will discover new non-medical applications for brain-computer interface devices. Neuralink's long-term vision is to create BCIs that are sufficiently safe and powerful that the general population would want to have them. Neuralink understands that medical devices need to be secure, and it takes serious engineering to prevent unwanted access to such devices. Security will be built into every layer of the product through strong cryptography, defensive engineering, and extensive security auditing.